Intestinal nematodes. Important intestinal nematodes are Strongyloides turcoralis, Ankylostoma duodenale, Ascaris lumbricoides. All these three are small intestinal nematodes, whereas the Entrobius vermicularis and Trichuris trichura are large intestinal nematodes. Ankylostoma duodenale is called as hookworm. Ascaris lumbricoides is roundworm. Entrobius vermicularis is pinworm. And Trichuris trichura is whipworm. For Ascaris, Entrobius and Trichuris trichura, the infective form is the egg. Let's see about the hookworm, which is Ankylostoma duodenale. Here the word ankylo means hooked, stoma means mouth, duodenale because it lives in the duodenum, which is a part of small intestine, which is a hooked parasite with a mouth and it lies in the small intestine. Important clinical manifestation of Ankylostoma duodenale is it causes iron deficiency anemia. Morphology, there are two forms: the egg, which hatches in the soil, and the larva, which is the infective form. This is the difference between the Necator americanus and the Ankylostoma duodenale. The Necator americanus is the new world hookworm, whereas the Ankylostoma duodenale is the old world hookworm. In Ankylostoma duodenale, it has 6 teeth. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 2 teeth posteriorly, 6 teeth, whereas the Necator americanus has 4 chitinous plates like this, 2 over here and 2 here, 4 chitinous plates. So the Ankylostoma duodenale causes more severe iron deficiency anemia because of these teeth than in Necator americanus. The egg. Hookworm egg is oval in shape, non-bile stain, so it is colorless. It consists of a smooth outer membrane and an irregular inner membrane. This is the irregular inner membrane. And the embryo is situated within the inner membrane. It is a segmented embryo in its blastomere stage. All these are the blastomeres, segmented embryo. And also there is a clear space between the shell and the embryo. Clear space, shell and the embryo. This is the hookworm egg. Next is the larva. This is the male larva and this is the female larva. The male larva has a cloacal aperture and a copulatory bursa in its posterior end, whereas the female has the ovary situated in the middle and its end is pointed and sharp. Difference between the male and female larva. Male is smaller in size compared to female, which is longer. Copulatory bursa is present posteriorly in case of male, but it is absent in case of female. Posterior end is expanded due to the presence of copulatory bursa in male, and the posterior end is pointed tail in case of female. Genital opening opens in the cloaca with anus in case of males, and the genital opening is separate in the middle in case of females. Stages of larva. Has 4 stages of larva, L1 to L4, out of which important is L1 and L3. L1 is rhabdidiform larva, L3 is the filariform larva, which is the infective form. This is an image showing the egg, rhabdidiform larva, and the adult hookworm, Ankylostoma duodenale. Now coming to the life cycle. It has only one host, that is the man. Infective stage is the filariform larva, L3 stage of larva. Mode of transmission is through skin penetration. So what happens is, firstly, the eggs from the feces of human, they are passed in the soil, and in the soil the rhabdidiform larva hatches and it develops into the filariform larva in the environment. So this filariform larva is the infective stage again to the human. The filariform larva penetrates the skin and the larva exits circulation in the lungs. They are then coughed up and swallowed. Ankylostoma species larvae can become developmentally arrested and dormant in the tissues. Reactivation may enter the small intestine. So here will be the adult worm in the small intestine. So another summary of life cycle. In the humans, the filariform larva is the infective stage, penetrates the skin, enters the circulation, from there it reaches the lungs, trachea, pharynx. From the pharynx it is re-swallowed, gets into the GIT, attaches to the small intestine and matures into the L4 larva, finally the adult form. And the adult lays eggs. These eggs are passed in the feces, which is the diagnostic stage. This feces enters the external environment, converts into the labditiform larva by hatching, and the labditiform larva present in the soil then grows into filariform larva, which then becomes again the infective stage. This is the life cycle of hookworm, both Ankylostoma duodenale and Echator americanus. Next is the pathogenicity. The hookworm attaches to the mucosal wall of the intestine and it sucks the blood, causing muscular esophageal contraction, secretes hydrotic enzymes and anticoagulant like factor 7A. By these enzymes and anticoagulant, it penetrates the skin with the help of mainly the proteolytic enzyme aspartyl protease and hyaluronidase. Clinical features. First, features due to migrating larva. The migrating larva produces cutaneous larva migraines due to skin penetration at the site of penetration. Also, it causes skin rashes, ground itch and serpiginous tract. This is the cutaneous larva migraines. The serpiginous tract. Next, the clinical manifestations due to the adult worm in the intestine. In the early intestinal phase, there is less warm blood. So there is only epigastric pain, diarrhea and eosinophilia. Whereas in the late intestinal phase, the worm load increases, due to which there is iron deficiency anemia and protein malnutrition seen. And there is something called as Wakana disease. When the Ankylostoma duodenale is ingested by oral route, it causes both GI and pulmonary symptoms. So this is called as Wakana's disease. Commonly the route of entry is through skin penetration, but when it ingested by oral route, it causes both GI as well as pulmonary symptoms. This is called as Wakana's disease. Next is the lab diagnosis. First is stool microscopy. It shows null bind stained oval segmented egg. Next is stool culture. Stool culture is performed in agar plate technique charcoal culture, Bierman funnel technique, Hardamori filter paper tube method. Other findings include hypochromic microcytic anemia due to iron deficiency, eosinophilia, and hypoalbuminemia. Lastly, coming to the treatment, the treatment is either by giving antiparasitic drugs and also by symptomatic treatment. Antiparasitic drugs include albendazole, mebendazole, and pyrantelpamoate. For symptomatic treatment, oral iron is given to treat iron deficiency anemia, and also nutritional support is given. Now let's see a few parasites causing anemia. Hookworm, that is the Necator americanus and Ankylostoma duodenale, causes anemia, and also the whipworm, which is Trichuris trichura. These two are nematodes causing iron deficiency anemia. Next is the blood fluke. Blood fluke schistosoma, which is a trematode, also causes anemia. These are the four important parasites causing anemia. This is all about hookworm. Thank you.